Experts have continued to underscore the need for policies that prioritize human and environmental well-being alongside economic growth. These sentiments were raised by Herbert Kafero, the Programs and Communications Officer at Seattin Uganda, during a dialogue held under the theme Harnessing Youth Voices and Investment Policies, Laws and Agreements for Decent Work, Green Jobs and Sustainable Development in Uganda. It was noted that it's critical for the youth to understand and advocate for investment policies that prioritize decent work and not just any job to move from the unemployed class.
Today we have engaged young people on harnessing youth voices to foster decent work, green jobs and sustainable development in Uganda. Seattini believes that this young generation is the next breed of policymakers and is the next breed of leaders. So it is important to engage young people on investment-related policies and how we can use our Investment Code Act 2019 to address challenges that our young people are facing.
Whereas there is a need to curb the high rate of unemployment, the government was challenged to generate opportunities that do not necessarily produce cheap labor, as it doesn't equal progress. Meanwhile, Professor Ezra Sruma observed that the government needs to align part of the oil revenues into social protection of its citizens.
We are looking at compiling all the views and concerns that have been shared by the youth in today's dialogue on harnessing youth voices on investment policies to foster decent work, green jobs and sustainable development in Uganda. All the deliberations are going to culminate into a manifesto, which is dubbed Manifesto on Making Investment Policies Work for the Youth in Uganda.
As a country, we should adopt social protection for everyone, for all citizens, so that no one is allowed to fall into a subhuman state. Subhuman means you have a disabled person who has no access to food, or you have an orphan who has nobody to look after them, that there is some arrangement in line with other civilized countries whereby the revenues from oil are set aside so that the earnings from those revenues will be used to make social protection possible, so that in times of desperation, in times of unemployment, in times of old age, in times of illness, this is social health insurance, there is some way in which care is provided.
The dialogue, among other things, sought to enhance the capacity of the youth to appreciate the role of investment policies towards fostering decent work and sustainable development, and also garner youth views and perspectives on Uganda's investment policy regime and energy transition inform COP 2019 discussions.